Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Invicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody for the support. No, I'm not better yet, unfortunately. I feel like I'm getting the, I'm headed towards the worst before it starts getting better. Seed Day is going to be Tango November, Romeo Romeo 9-2, Charlie November. We have the Book of Sin, which is a good spacebar item, and Little Brimstone, which is an acceptable passive item, follower. Good damage, good tears rate, acceptable movement speed, and we also got 3 HP now, so that's not bad. But people have been asking me what am I sick with. It's just, it's my usual, basically, I haven't been sick in a while, but I used to have a chronic problem with, sinus infections, and that's sort of where I'm at right now. It's been about, probably, I'd say almost a year since I've actually had one, so I was a little bit surprised. I mean, we might as well look for a crawl space. We're gonna get this bomb back anyway, so it's really inconsequential to use that bomb there. But I was actually really surprised at how little I've been sick this in 2018, because honestly, I usually get sick once every, oh, I don't know. It's like with the I call it the gunk. It's usually, let me pick that up. It's usually once every like 4 months or so. So like almost 3 times a year, I would get this sort of sickness. Ooh, wow, this is that's a tough. Tough choice. I think I'm going to have to still stick with the Book of Sin, though. I like Unicorn Stomp. Unicorn Stomp gives you temporary invincibility at the cost of not being able to do damage with it, nor are you able to use weapons except orbitals. But given where we are right now in this run, the Book of Sin just has way more upside than giving us, you know, occasional invincibility. If we had an orbital, I might consider that. Actually, I wouldn't consider it. I would take it. It's still possible we could get an orbital here off the first boss. But yeah, I call it the gunk. It's not really something that I suffer from that much. It usually lasts like a week and then it's gone after that. But like I said, it's almost been I would think probably a year since I've actually had the gunk. And it hasn't hit me in full force yet. But I know it's coming, because in the past couple of days, the reason why my voice sounds a little bit more hoarse than usual is because I actually have not had the usual associated cough with the gunk until very recently. Get old bandage. It's going to give us a red heart HP. We're going to head on down to the next floor. I'm not really going to care about going trying to get to the store or anything like that. So when the cough gets here, you know it's going to be the worst is yet to come. Because honestly, that's what wipes me out, is having the persistent cough. And it's just nastiness, so. But enough about my Tuesday. How's your Tuesday going? I am planning on recording I'm actually recording this pretty early on Monday. And I'm planning on doing a Lobotomy Corporation today. So you should see a Lobotomy Corporation episode today. Hopefully it's not a super long one, but who freaking knows in that game, man. Like, the runs are starting to get more and more intense. And again, sorry about the sniffles. I'm trying, man. I really am trying. I don't like recording when I'm sick, but I also I don't like being broke, so there's not much all I can really do about that except just work. So, okay, alright, well, don't really care about a red heart. If we could just get, like, a key, that'd be cool. Little Brimstone, by the way, is the name of our follower. I know I've said it already. And it's very good. Especially early on, Little Brimstone can really carry you through some tough spots. I'm not a huge fan of Little Brimstone, only just because of the fact that I sort of treat Little Brimstone like Lilith, but I think that calling Little Brimstone as bad as Lilith is disingenuous, because Little Brimstone is a good item. By the way, the Super Secret Room is guaranteed to be over here. 100%. If I get a bomb, I will bet my credibility on that. And if I'm incorrect, then you know what? I'll just blame it on me being sick. Isaac trying to get a little cheeky there with the 2 invisible mobs, not just one. As you see here, we're utilizing the range of Little Brimstone, which is honestly our greatest strength right now. Okay, because, like, we would, like, love a bomb and a key. If you're wondering why I went into the store, it is because I wanted to... Hey, there we go. Ace of Hearts, by the way, does turn everything into hearts. And it can give you an Eternal Heart or a Soul Heart, which we just got. If you're wondering why I went to the store, it's because basically I thought that maybe we would have a bomb or a key in there. Yeah, good freaking luck on that one, I guess. I didn't have to buy that playing card, obviously, but I was hoping it was going to be either a Joker card or two diamonds. Or really anything but, like, any of the heart cards. And, of course, as luck would have it, we got a heart card. But that heart card did give us an extra soul heart, so maybe that's going to come through in a big way. Who really knows? I am planning on moving forward with a with the item tournament. The one that I spoke about last week. Get Synthoil, is going to be damage and range. And we get the Pact and Gimpy. Now, if I had to choose here between the two, we want to take the Pact. But what's interesting about the Pact is that it will give you two Soul Hearts upon acquisition. So we're going to actually take both of these, and it's only going to cost us one Soul Heart. And our Red Heart damage. Our Red Heart HP, of course. Okay, so we made it through there, trying not to get hit. Now we just got to squeeze this way. There we go. So with the Pact, it's going to give us a big tears up as well as a good amount of damage. And we've got ourselves a pretty solid start here. The Book of Sin, of course, is going to give us consumable items every time we use it. Could be a battery, could be a bomb, could be a key, could be a soul heart, could be regular hearts, could be pills. It could be tarot cards. You never know. That's why the Book of Sin is so dang good. We are able to get a bomb, so I am going to go check out the super secret room, the one that I guaranteed was there. Hopefully we get another one, because I would love to get into, like, or at least hopefully we get a key so I can get in our freaking item room. Or maybe Book of Sin could just give us a key. I mean, we've had, you know, the Book of Sin this entire floor, and it hasn't gotten us a key yet, I'm just saying. Or maybe it got us one, that's how we got in the store, I don't remember. I'm still sick. Hey, look at that. We are able to get it, and we even get a soul heart too, man. Alright, well, we lucked out on that one. Inside of our item room is going to be stem cells. I will take the Red Heart HP upgrade. I'm not a huge fan. Apparently, stem cells also has a range upgrade associated with it. I did not know that. I'm not a huge fan of taking a Red Heart HP here, but I think about... I go back and catalog what all we've gotten on this floor. And we've gotten everything that we need except for, like, more Red Hearts to take more deals with the devil later on. Okay, well, now you're just making me look like an idiot, game, and I maybe I do appreciate it, maybe I don't. I don't know. Another soul heart here. That'd be for me to know and for you to find out. I am going to go back, since we have multiple HP upgrades now, with Speed Bag. I do want some money for this HP. Or as the Brits say, HP. There's a luck upgrade there and the green tinted penny. But anyway, going back to the item tournament, I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to call it yet, but I want to poll my Isaac, not my Isaac community, but the Isaac community in general, who watches my stuff. I'd like to get a tournament, like an elimination bracket style tournament, to see what everyone thinks is the ultimate item in Isaac. So it's how I'm going to present it is every video that I'll do, I'll probably present like five different scenarios or five different matchups per video, and then people can vote on it during the week, and then I'll announce the winners, the ones that will move on, and then yada yada yada. But it would be something like, you know, you can either pick one or the other. Which one would you take? Would you take Magic Mush, or would you take like Maw of the Void, or you know, Dr. Fetus versus Epic Fetus, and then the winner of that would go on to the next round, and then, you know, just I think something like that would be really neat. And as everyone knows, I like to be interactive with my audience as much as I can. I mean, hell, we did an entire Darkest Dungeon season based on that premise. So I'd love to do something with Isaac. I think that'd be fun. I'm interested to see which item would get voted. Excuse me. I'm gonna need another replay on that one, because I don't know what hit me there. Unless, for some odd reason, there was creep there, but... The only thing I can think of is that it was a green champion. I honestly wasn't paying attention to the color of the champion. And it left a creep trail behind that was masked by the water. Not sure. Is this a one run? I mean, probably it is. Probably. Yeah, it may have been a green champion. I just didn't notice the creep. Man, Book of Sin just rocking and rolling right now. Yeah, we could use a key if we get one. Yeah, we got a bomb and a key. That's even better. What's better than a key? A bomb and a key. Which is very different from ball and a cup, by the way. Super happy to have football coming back. For those of you who don't watch American football, that's not going to mean anything to you. But those of you who do, you know the football season starts this Thursday. And I could not be happier. Football is a sport that I've played for many years, and I've watched for even longer. But the last couple of seasons, I've just not really been, like, I've not really been caring that much. And some of it does have to do with, like, the fact of, like, you know, there's like so much politics now that we're hearing inside of sports, not just football, but just sports in general. So that sort of had a little bit of an impact on my enjoyment of, like, of what's been going on lately. Get more options. More options is going to give us a double item room. Or basically, it's not technically a double item room. It's a two item item room, not double. Double would for some reason, if I say we have a double item room, that means that we get, like, two on the same floor. You see what I mean? By the way, we got sinus infection, IRL, and in-game. And luck would have it, we would go the wrong way. I'm just trying to find our item room here before we go into the next floor game. But hey, you know, whatever. But yeah, I haven't really been excited for football in quite a while. And this is the first season I am actually really looking forward to. It seems like almost every team, even Cleveland, like, has, like, a decent shot at going places this season. Although I have been seeing rumors and like a smattering of articles calling the Bills apparently is now the worst. They're the worst team in the NFL, even though the season hasn't started. It's like, okay. All right. So we're gonna start making those calls, are we? We're gonna start calling teams. This is the worst team without even playing a single down in the regular season. All right. Those are just like, I don't know, those are the same thing. That's the equivalent of sports ball tabloids. Ooh, shiny, or Lucky Rock. Lucky Rock's interesting. I don't know if I want it over Sinus Infection. Sinus Infection is going to give us more damage. Basically, those booger tears that you see, they'll stick to an enemy and actually do a fairly significant amount of damage. Get Death's List from Fallen. Now we'll just go to the next floor. We got Mini Mush as well. Mini Mush is going to give us a movement speed upgrade as well as a range upgrade. It does contribute to the fungi transformation. I'm looking forward to it. My team is Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I'm sure most of you probably are aware of that. And if not, then hey, my favorite team is the Tampa Bay Buccaneers for some stupid reason. I don't have faith in the Bucs this year. I hate to be that fan. I hate to be one who poo-poos my team even before, like, a single down has been played, but I just don't like... I just don't really like our team all that much. I really don't. I mean, that's all I can really say. Like, this is the Bucks problem. The Bucks problem is they keep putting too much faith in what I would consider as, like, say, oh, let's just call them not great quarterbacks. Yeah, the only quarterback that I truly thought was really, really good for the Bucs, at least in the system anyway, was probably Brad Johnson. And it may be coincidental that, you know, that happens to be the only quarterback that Tampa Bay has ever won a Super Bowl with, but yeah, that's sort of how. Careful. And this is another thing that, like, I sort of have a problem with lately with Tampa is that I don't like that our defense has become sort of like this joke. Like, back in the heyday, back in, like, the early to mid-2000s era, and even into the 2010s, like, Tampa was known for the Tampa 2 defense. I mean, it's coined. That is a legitimate style of lineup for a defensive lineup in the National Football League, coined the Tampa 2. And it was derived from, you know, one of the best, if not the best, defenses that Tampa's ever had. But, like, now it's kind of like, oh, yeah, we just don't have a defense. We have to solely care about offense. And I'm not a fan of that. I played defense in football, so that I also might be a little bit biased in that, but I really hate when a team has a bad defense. You know, yeah, I mean, the offense puts up the big numbers, and yeah, you know, they get all the flashy plays and that sort of thing, but as a former defensive player, I can tell you that I value a good defense over a good offense. Yeah, it's exciting to watch good offenses, but for me, it's equally as exciting to watch good defenses. I'm just saying. Blue Baby's Soul, no. I mean, again, Nose Goblin's just better. By the way, it's called Nose Goblin, not Science Infection. I misspoke on that one. Science Infection is a completely different item. Which essentially does the same thing, though. I'm not convinced that the secret room, super secret room, is below us here. It looks, it wants me to think that it is, but now that I know that there's an adjacent room to it, I know it's not. It's also not the regular secret room. We're moving at a pretty good pace, though. I mean, Mom's Contact's good. Ooh, Card Against Humanity. Now we're talking. By the way, Card Against Humanity was another one of those cards. When I was trying to name off the playing cards, that's another one that shows up with the playing card pack. I picked up Blue Baby's Soul for now, just because we're gonna be back in that hallway anyway. I just want to go over here and use Card Against Humanity. So this is why Card Against Humanity is awesome, because of this right here. You might be looking at this and thinking, like, why is this awesome? Well, assuming you get the Petrified Poop, which we don't have, but even if you don't, as you see here, it's able to produce you a lot more money. And it can also give you hearts, it can give you soul hearts, eternal hearts, it can give you a whole shebang of stuff. So, you might think that the Card Against Humanity card is really not all that great, but it actually is. Now, obviously, it does help if you have Stompy, or if you have, like, a little Brimstone, for example, to be able to clear multiple poop piles, but I have, I have been known on occasion to not care about that, and, even with bad tears, like, I still, like, yeah, this is just happening. You're gonna have to deal with it. Now, unfortunately, we did not get a key. Death's List, by the way, is the item that I talk about frequently. One of those items I sort of wrote off, and then, like, I actually know this item's top tier. You have the little white skull that appears on enemies' heads, and as long as you don't kill them out of order, if you kill them being the enemies with the white skulls on their head, in order, you gain a variety of benefits. Could be stat ups, could be items, could be really anything. Except an item. By item, I mean consumable. I'm only doing this because I want the extra soul heart here. And we'll just head on down. I mean, yeah, I could probably have done a full clear to look for, like, a key or something and try to get to the store, but, like, it's not that big of a deal. Sorry about the alt tab here. I'm getting blown up. Make sure everything's okay. I'm not getting blown up. I'm just saying that my mom is blowing me up here. Okay, everything's okay. She's very excited. She went to the Houston Astros game, and she got to sit behind home plate in, like, the second row. And we could see her on TV, so that was fun. You know how excited moms can get. So she thinks it's neat. I think it's neat too. To my knowledge, I don't think I've ever been on TV. I hope I'm not on TV anytime soon or ever. The only time you might see me on TV is, like, if I win the lottery and I just don't care anymore. That's about the only scenario that I can see myself ever being seen on TV. Yeah, so that white skull you see above this one, I don't know why. For some reason, the skull was still there. That's a little bit weird. Oh, yeah, we have a key. What was I thinking? Keys are kind of sparse right now. Yeah, it's funny, game. We've been seeing a lot of golden chests pop out of tinted rocks lately, too, which I'm not a huge fan of. Apparently, I guess that last keeper spawned a fly that ruined our deaths list. And I'll say it, I've said it before many times, every time we get deaths list, I'll say it again. Deaths list is not worth prioritizing getting hit over. So don't do it. So if you have to choose between getting hit or trying to complete the deaths list task, unless if you have just tons of HP and you just don't care if you get hit or if it's just inconsequential, then obviously don't try to go for deaths list. So we get Magic Mush. Still my favorite item. Not my favorite item, but definitely the item that I still consider the best item in the entire game. And people have been trying to argue that. Somebody was like, oh, Mom's Knife Brimstone's way better than Magic Mush. I disagree. Only for the sense that those two are hard carry items. And I don't really consider them in this respect, because when I'm talking about, not that those items aren't good, of course, but when I say the best item in the game, value-wise, like, what item has the most value in the game, and what would be considered the best item for the value? In one fell swoop, with Magic Mush, you're getting all stats up, minus tiers, a damage multiplier, and an HP up. And you think, like, I try to also think about how many runs I've lost with Brimstone and Mom's Knife versus how many runs I've lost with Magic Mush. Gotta be honest, I don't think I've ever lost a run with Magic Mush. I probably have, but I just can't think of one. But that's what I mean when I'm talking about, like, consider when something's up for consideration for the best overall item in the entire game. That's what I mean. Now, as far as my favorite hard carry items go, I don't know what the deal has been lately. It seems like for some reason, maybe there's a keyboard input lag or something going on. It seems like none of my movements stop when I'm telling it to. Cause like I purposely like try to swing to avoid hitting that lock. Actually, surprise, it's not there. And we still hit it. Oh, okay. We'll just get double tapped, I guess, by the same mask. Fine. All right. Super secret room might be here. We got a moving speed up prayer. We're moving way too fast right now. There it is. Like, we're moving way too fast. It could also just be a symptom of me just not being 100% here mentally right now, just because I'm in sort of a fever state. Maybe not a fugue state, but definitely a fever state. I don't know. If you can, if someone out there can find a run that I've lost on YouTube after taking Magic Mush, please let me know. You're gonna have to do some digging. I'm not gonna take Super Bandage here, and I'm gonna take both of these and then take Super Bandage. The logic behind that is that if we ended up not getting a great Devil Deal, I didn't want to have extra Red Heart HP. But since I took both of them, if you're wondering why I took the Necronomicon, by the way, because it does count towards the Bookworm transformation. That's literally the only reason why I would ever take that item. Whenever I talk about being a Tampa Bay fan, the first thing people ask me is, "What do you think of Jameis Winston?" I don't like Winston. I didn't like him in college, and I don't like him in Tampa. I still don't like him. I think he could be a good player. He can definitely be a good quarterback, but he's a butthead outside of football. And I think he was a little bit overrated in college, but that's just me. Could be biased on that. I've never been convinced that Tampa's ever had a great quarterback. The darkest days as a Tampa Bay fan were the Chris Sims days. I got ragged on so hard by my friends the day that on the draft, I don't remember what year it was probably 2006 or something, where Chris Sims got drafted by Tampa. I was like, are you kidding? Because I strongly dislike Phil Sims. Definitely do not like him at all. And I didn't like Chris Sims at Texas, especially, you know, being around Texas A&M. And when Tampa selected him for the draft, their final pick, man, that was the worst. Anyway, enough sports ball talk.
Well, we don't care about sports, Victor. We just want to watch you play Isaac.
I'm trying. I'm going to take Maya's Touch over. Hey, listen, Maya's Touch will at least give us a little bit more money. Not that we've had any money issues here, but it would be nice to be able to have that shut down. Okay. I didn't think it was going to be there, but wow, we even get... We can get charged, baby. I will buy a key because keys just don't freaking exist at this point. And we'll just donate. We've been putting a lot of money back. Look at that. We're at 631. Midas Touch will give us a contact damage buff. So anytime something touches us in any way, we deal contact damage. And then that damage is based off of how much money we're currently holding. And it's something ridiculous. If you have 99 cents, Midas Touch does a redonkulous amount of damage, and it is quite nice. Another nice thing about Midas Touch is that it will freeze everything that it touches you, including mom's feet, bosses. And if you destroy them while they're frozen, while they turn into gold, you actually gain money from that. And it's a pretty nice chunk of money as well. Super Secret Room might be here. I'd be surprised if it is. It is calling me surprised. Ooh, Crabbed Crown. Gotta go Crack Crown. Breaks the tears cap for us. It literally, there's no downside to having it. You saw there, you can actually do contact damage on mom's foot but just by walking up and touching it. And again, you can get extra damage there for freezing mom's foot as well. No deal with the devil. Kind of a surprise there. I actually meant to take the negative there, but that's alright. Glad a lot of people are starting to see the ways of Teleporter 2.0. Teleport 2.0. Golden Teleporter. Whatever you want to say. It's a fantastic item, man. Like, why does there have to be a room that just have spikes within the first step, Tyrone? What is the point of that other than to just catch the sleeping YouTuber? Which is the favorite game that Mathis has played on his channel, by the way. Sorry, I don't even want that penny. So you see the skull moving there with Deathless. We actually got a soul heart off of Deathless as well. Moon card's gonna be great. Teleports us into the, you know what? I don't even want that penny. I still don't want that penny. You can keep it. I'm really trying to hold back on the coughing. I've always had sinus problems. Sinus issues for me, man, that's just like I was talking about yesterday. It's almost comforting in a little way, the fact whenever I get the gunk, because it's like, okay, I actually, as dumb as this sounds, I actually sleep better when I'm sick. Like this. And if you missed the explanation as to why that is yesterday, it's basically, it comes down to me unconsciously knowing that my brain doesn't have to work at the speed that it usually does, which prevents me from sleeping pretty well. Because my brain's like, okay, we're sick. We don't have to do anything. We can just relax and play Path of Exile or Summoner's War. You know, Summoner's War has been kind of ticking me off lately. I don't know why. For those of you who don't play Summoner's War, that's not going to make any sense, so I won't dwell on it very long. But for those of you who do, like, why don't they just ban violent runes in PvP? PvE, I don't care about. No one, I mean, that's not competitive, but man. For those of you who don't play it, just as a really TLDR, with violent runes are basically a set bonus. If you equip 4 violent runes on the same monster in Summoner's War, you have a chance, a complete RNG, you have a chance to get it, to gain an extra turn. Now, that may not sound like a big deal to you all, but in a turn-based combat system, getting an extra turn means that not only do you get a chance to act again, you also lower all your cooldowns, like all your extended cooldowns, by one round. Because obviously you're taking an extra turn. I mean, that's just how it works. And in Summoner's War, they actually let you... You can just get screwed. Like, you can just flat out just get screwed by RNG, because someone got more violent procs than you. Or maybe, like, in my case, I never get violent procs, so it brings a lot of randomness to the game, which I'm not a fan of. picture the, and for those of you who still are a little bit confused, picture it this way. Think about having a card for Hearthstone that everybody has, right? And the card can roll 50-50 either yes or no. If it lands on yes, you gain an extra, you gain your mana back to go to just take a completely second action on that particular turn. And then you don't get it. And then they get it again. That's the power that we're talking about here. And it's really freaking ridiculous, and it's also like super rage inducing. There's nothing more tilting in Summoner's War to lose than to lose in PvP because someone got more violent procs than you. It's aggravating, man. And like, I was doing Siege today, and I lost half of my matches all because like they're freaking like this one dude Chasun violence procs violent four times in a row, not only healing herself back up to full, but then buffing everyone's weapon stats and healing everyone else back to full when I almost had her dead. Anyway, I'm surprised I didn't get hit there. Obviously, Dark Bum. By the way, Dark Bum's going to take all red hearts that we find, and for every, and pick them up off the ground. For every 1.5 red hearts that he picks up, we have a chance of getting a soul heart. Or he could also give us a spider. Or he could give us an attack spider. Most of the time, Dark Bum's pretty good about paying out in soul hearts. He used to be super overpowered back in the day. If you're wondering how he was super overpowered, it's because he took every single heart and had a chance to pay out with a soul heart, which was super redonkulously OP and also super amazing Wagon Adventure. Another item that used to be super OP that isn't anymore, Krampus's head. And you might be thinking, like, how is the head of Krampus even possible that used to be like an overpowered item? The head of Krampus, back in the original release for Rebirth, the head of Krampus had a 3-room cooldown. So, yeah, you can imagine how strong it is to have that item, and it also didn't twirl like it does now, which is stupid. So you had guaranteed damage on your target. 3 rooms. Every 3 rooms, you just had a ton of damage. And though you can go back and watch those early Rebirth runs on my channel, and you can just, every time I get the head of Krampus, I usually just say, yeah, we win. Same goes for Darkbone. We win. We win the run. That's just it. You know what? Little Brimstone's gonna have his way with you, Isaac. Or not. Right. Question mark card is gonna allow us to use our spacebar item twice. Probably have full HP. I'd be surprised if we didn't. Our damage is fan freaking tastic thanks to Magic Mush. Of course, Small Rock also beneficial in huge ways. Hoping that we get a deal with the devil here. Did not. You know what? Yeah, let's just go. Let's go. What do you have to do? You ain't got to do anything today. It's a Tuesday, day after Labor Day. I hope everyone enjoyed their holiday. I'm gonna go ahead and use the disguise rune just because we didn't get a curse, thankfully. Look at our damage. Our DPS is so good because of the fact that we have cracked crown and we've broken the tears cap. And people have been asking me, what do you mean by that? Whenever you hear someone say like we've broken the cap, that means that there's an item or a stat that was hard capped, or in other words, there's a maximum limit to whatever a certain stat can go. And for the tears in particular, the tears cap is 5. So right now you see that we have a 4 next to our tears rate. Or tier delay. And that means that we've broken the cap because it's supposed to be at 5. So that allows us to go beyond and plus ultra our tiers rate. That's right. That's right. I watched that there anime. I don't know any anime, but I did have an Auntie May once. She made some good home pudding. I like My Hero Academia. Or Academia. I flip flop because I hear people call it Academia, and then also I also hear people say Academia, which is how it's said in the show. But it's a really good anime. I like it. Really, really good. I've talked about it in length before, but highly recommend. If you're kind of like an anime newbie like I used to be, and you're looking like for like your first anime to watch. My first anime was Naruto, and I still enjoy Naruto. I didn't watch the last couple episodes of Shippuden just because it was like, I don't know. I wasn't exactly sure if it was going to be the end, and then like when it ended, I was like, oh, that was the final episode, so I guess it's over? But the only other anime I've seen other than that is Bleach, and I really liked Bleach as well. Bleach had a huge impact on the PvP videos in Season 2. And it's my little subtle, not so subtle nod, which no one got. So I guess it was too subtle. Who knows? Which no one got to Bleach. Whenever I would do a title card intro for every episode of The Word of Law, it would say TWOL 1 or TWOL 13. That would do different title cards. Just it's a little homage. I used a couple of clips from the Bleach soundtrack as well. Every now and then. But My Hero Academia is very enjoyable. I definitely would say it's a very easy anime to get into as far as, like, if you've never seen anime before. Very entertaining. Mama Mega. How you doing, Mama Mega? I didn't even see you were there. I mean, we have HP, like, coming out of every orifice right now. MVP of this run, gotta go to Book of Sin. As much as I want to give it to Magic Mush, Book of Sin kept us safe early on. Oh, he actually fights Stanley. 2-1000, 3-1000. Slightly early. The Mama Mega explosion threw me off a bit. Somebody asked me if they thought when I was gonna. They basically asked me if do I think I will break 50,000 subs by this time or something. And I think it was this week. And I said I don't really know. I mean, it's that sort of thing. That sort of prediction stuff is stuff that I've never really been down with. And it's not that I don't care, because obviously I do care. It's just that like I don't think that way. Like, I don't try to predict something that isn't set in stone, and then, like, you kind of set yourself up for disappointment in a little way, you know what I mean? Like, what was funny was, I don't remember who it was, somebody was counting down, there were a fairly big YouTuber, I mean, fairly is, you know, kind, I mean, yeah, they were looking for a million subs or whatever, and they did, like, a live stream to, like, do a live stream countdown of when they were going to hit a million subs on YouTube, and what happened was the polar opposite happened. People got wind of the stream and actually started mass unsubbing, and it was a big fail. I think the guy ended up eventually getting a million anyway. I honestly don't remember who it was, but I was just looking at that. And I was like, see, it's not that I can't. Wow, yeah, I'll tell you. No, I don't want Baby Bender. Baby Bender's good, but I'd rather have the Broken Tears cap. But I'm just like, see, I feel like I just can't. You just can't predict that, you know. That's it. Comes off. It comes off as a little bit pretentious. If I were to say, like, yeah, I expect to break 50,000 subs next week. It's like, why? why would you? Why would? What makes you think that's going to happen? The exact opposite could happen. You know, and I'm not. Again, I'm not. No, I'm not. We've had missing no once this year. That's good enough for me. Plus, we're about to fight Delirium, and I do not want to get something that is an unwinnable combo against Delirium. I'm not trying to disrespect this particular YouTuber, if you know who I'm talking about. I'm not calling them pretentious. I'm saying the idea that I would do it, I would feel like I'm being pretentious by saying, like, yeah, I expect to get a 50,000 sub by next week. This is my long roundabout fever state fueled running rant about me saying I basically don't have any expectation as to when I'm going to hit 50,000 subs. I know it's going to happen. I just don't know when. And I'm not going to plan around it because I think that's just, I've already just talked about that. But you'll have to forgive me. My brain is, it's working like twice the speed that it has been in the last 2 days. All while I'm trying not to die to delirium, which of course isn't going to happen, but you know, you still got to be careful. Like we're not really, you know, blowing them out of the water right now. In fact, we're not doing that much damage to them at all, really. Which is odd because I thought we were doing way more damage to them than we got 16 damage. Thank you, Gimpy. Delirium Death just sat there smiling at us. Thank you, Dark Bum. That was Charge Baby giving us a full charge, by the way. This is a very odd Delirium fight. There's a lot of stuff, like, happening. Strangely, we're not hitting Delirium at all. There you go. There's Chad. Delira Chad. Whoa there, so you can settle down. Yeah, now Delirium, I think the scariest Delirium form is definitely Brownie. Delirium Brownie or Delirium Mama Mega or Mama Gertie are pretty awful. But going back to the item tournament though, I think that's going to be a lot of fun. I hope it's going to be a lot of fun for people. People seem to enjoy the thought. It is going to require some post-production, I think. I was trying to think of, like, could I do this without having post-production, and I think I'd be able to, but it would come off really janky. So, I might do an overall, like, I shouldn't even say anything, really, but it's too late now. I may do, like, an overall non-post-editing one first, just to see if I can get it done in a presentable fashion in OBS. And if I can't, then I'll just go on full production, but just know that if I have to do full production, it's going to take stuff way longer to come out, which is the reason why I don't usually do post-production editing. This is a pretty long Delirium fight. To be quite honest, if I had known that this Delirium fight was going to take this long, I wouldn't have done it. I thought that with 16.75 damage, we would have been done, like, minutes ago. But for some odd reason, it just doesn't seem like Delirium's taking a whole lot of damage. He's also, like, bugging out and teleporting a lot more often than usual. So this should be the end of him. Oh, I didn't even see that Gemini behind us. Yeah, there we go. See, this is what we want. We want the multiple segmented bosses here. Dude, there's so many things spawning. Why? Like, I don't think I've ever seen a Delirium fight have that many spawns in it at once. Crazy. Anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this one. I'm going to re-record with Bottom Corporation now, so stay tuned for that. Thank you for supporting not only that series, but also, of course, the Isaac series here on the channel. Let me know down below what you think of the item vote off and your early predictions. I'd like to see that. I want to see exactly what everyone thinks might actually win that one. So we'll probably start that off sometime next week or whenever I feel better. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. You guys have been kicking butt on the likes or the dislikes. Either way, helps out support the channel. Subscribe and click the notification button so you get notified when my newest videos go live. As always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.